Microcasting for your city, Talkapolis.
Bandwidth for today's show is brought to you by SoftLayer.com. We love SoftLayer here at Talkapolis. They are the greatest hosting company ever. They make everything easy. Check out their website at SoftLayer.com. Thanks again for sponsoring the show.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Music Business Daily. I'm your host, Greta Gaines.
And I'm Shara Rivera.
Good to have you here.
We are here to give you all the hot music headlines.
That's right.
So let's get them started. Okay. Well, first off, ACDC is finally coming to iTunes. They said for years that they are not going to do it. Just back in 2008, they said, the lead singer, Brian Johnson, said, maybe I'm just being old-fashioned, but this is iTunes. God bless them. It's going to kill music if they're not careful. Music is dead. Now let there be rock. And then they've changed their tune now.
I wonder why.
Scroll up.
Can we see that picture of Angus Young? I mean, this man single-handedly popularized the striped tie and shorts look with the hat. And for that...
the little Scottish look.
Yeah, we are forever thankful.
Grateful.
Grateful, exactly.
We need to count our blessings since this is the day after Thanksgiving.
Yes.
We continue.
Gratitude. And I bet they're thankful that they finally got on flipping iTunes because they were missing out on billions of dollars.
They saw the Beatles making all that money last year, and they're like, well, if the Beatles can do it, I guess we can too. Mm-hmm. So their iTunes catalog is all 16 of their studio albums and both collections, their 4 live albums, and 3 compilation albums. So get on that and buy some iTunes.
Cool.
Also, the Alabama Shakes apparently declined a reality show appearance to be on The X Factor. Brittany Howard says it's a fucked up kind of show.
It says effed up.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. It could be something else.
She didn't want to do it because... she thought that there was bigger and better things in store for them than doing that show, and turned out she was right.
Well, she also says she doesn't like how people can just pick you apart, and it's up to them to how the show portrays you for people to pick whether they like you or not. And she said, I think there's a more fair way to have our music heard.
Yeah.
So, you know, and she was right. They didn't do that. And then the next year, they were signed to ATO Records, and now they're blowing up. And every time they play in Nashville, it's sold out within hours.
For every Brittany Howard out there, there's probably a few more who didn't do the X Factor for similar reasons who totally regret it.
There's probably hundreds.
Yes.
I would say.
Yeah. But
I love the Alabama Shakes, though.
I do, too.
I'm glad they weren't on X Factor.
They're a big fan.
Well, Record Store Day is coming up. It's today, actually. So you need to get down to Third Man Records because there's all kinds of fun things going on over there at Jack White's place.
They created a novelties lounge. You know, they expanded Third Man Records into some extra space, and now they have this whole Fun Times lounge.
Color photo booth, a Moldorama machine, where you can make miniature models of Jack White's guitar, just like it's like the pressing pennies, except you get a little mini guitar. There's a Willy Wonka chocolate factory. Oh, wait. Sorry. I got caught up. It's supposed to be a combination between Chuck E. Cheese Play Area and Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory.
What they mean by Chuck E. Cheese, for those of you who don't have kids, they have their own special tokens that you put in the machines, the Chuck E. Cheese tokens, and they're going to have a similar kind of tokens for the Fun Times.
It's all going on today, but you better get over there right now as soon as you see this because all the fun stuff's probably going to be gone because it's going to be so packed.
It's a good idea. He's full of them.
Well,
Jizza.
Yeah, from, the Wu-Tang Clan. He's working with a Columbia professor to bring hip-hop back into the classroom. Apparently, the way you say it? You say Jizza or...
I don't know. It looks like Guzza. I only know RZA.
Jizza?
But we're going to say Jizza. Who knew there was a RZA and a Jizza all in the Wu-Tang Clan? But here's the thing.
Well,
I thought it was to bring more science into
the
classroom.
Well, it is. I'm a little confused. He said that... he was watching this study back in 2009. The study was done and said 4% of African-American seniors weren't proficient in sciences.
But would you look at what they're doing in the classroom? He's having them go around in circles and practice their hip-hop, and I fail to see what that has to do with science.
I don't really either, but he just recently did some kind of music video where he was working and meeting with MIT physicists because he's also researching for an upcoming solo album. And so apparently he learned something from these physicists, and he was like, I've got to incorporate this into my music and help black kids. but I don't know how he's going to do this.
And he says, who knows, it could be even bigger than the spelling bee moving forward. But again, when you read the article, nothing to do with science.
And it really doesn't make sense, but he's all about it and been promoting it, how he's going to bring hip-hop slash science back into the classroom. We will see. We'll give you an update.
How those scores go.
Yeah.
After Jizz has been in the classroom.
Coming up from 4%, hopefully. Well, let's see. R.E.M., they've worked with James Franco to cast Lindsay Lohan in the James Franco-directed Blue video. So he's made a video of their song Blue and cast Lindsay Lohan in it. I think we should watch a piece of this.
Check it out. Love me some James Franco.
Where's Lindsay Lohan?
I don't know. They
let us fast forward it.
Take their time getting to the Lindsay Lohan part.
Oh, wait, I just saw her. There she is. She's not doing much acting, though. Oh, there she is again, being sexy. Oh,
where's her hand going?
It's all about the music, okay? Well, so I think that's enough of that. But you can watch the whole thing on YouTube.
It's pretty artsy.
Yeah.
Way to go, James Franco. Way to be deep.
I like the beginning a lot.
You do?
Yeah.
I like the end when it's over.
So, a Kurt Cobain documentary is coming out. It's a new ebook that features unreleased pictures of Cobain. And he has, there's all kinds of special things like his scrawlings and parts of his journals. One of the things is his top 50 all-time biggest albums.
His favorite top 50 albums. He makes a list and he crosses out a few things. And there's some
Surfer
interesting
Rosa,
bands on
from
there.
The Pixies, Beach Party Marine Girls.
Lead Belly, Mazzy Star, Clash, of course.
Sex Pistols, of course, the Beatles.
Pixies, one of his favorite bands. I like that Public Enemy makes the list. It's a nice eclectic list from
Rites
the man
Spring.
Who started grunge.
Yeah, so check it out. He has a lot of news lately. Last but not least, Carrie Underwood is saying that she's a fan of the show Nashville, but she's not as scandalous as it makes country singers out to be. So she says she loves the show because she lives here, of course, and she'll be like, hey, I eat there, and it represents our town really well.
But she, like a lot of us, can see where the soap opera meets the road here with the Nashville and that she probably
with the Nashville.
With the Nashville. With the maths. With the last show, I'm so confused. But what's cool, of course she's going to give props to the show. We don't know if there's any acting in Carrie's future.
Well, she was in that Jesus movie about the girl that got bit by the fish or the shark. There we go.
I missed that one.
I can't remember the name, but she was the Sunday school teacher or whatever, the youth counselor.
And Nemo. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that was Ellen
DeGeneres. No, it came out last year. We'll get into it later.
Okay.
But she said this is at the American Music Awards after she saying they were asking her about the show Nashville. So she's a fan. You're probably a fan. If you're all about Nashville, you're watching this show.
But you may not be as scandalous as some things that are happening on the show, and that's fine.
Or you might be.
TV.
You can be like, well, the show represents me well. I'm glad I live here.
I'm a big hussy and my mom's on meth. Just deal with it.
So, you're welcome.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us. We will see you next
Monday.
Week.
That's right.
Hope you had a great holiday and have
enjoy
a safe
weekend. Enjoy the weekend. Bye.
Microcasting for your city, Talkapolis.